Welcome to the lounge, folks. We're going to not have any of that lounge music, and we're going to dig right into this. I want to make sure my audio is working good, because last time I had a problem. I'm going to keep my face pressed to this microphone so that you can adjust your sound to the tone of my big old mouth. And by doing that, I don't have to worry about deafening you with a big blast from my face, and because often my face will blast sound. You know, come on, sometimes you belly laugh or something, you forget you're on a microphone, and you just like, you guffaw. But what we're going to do, I'm going to put something over here in this window. Hey, what's that, you say? That's another window. You know what Frank has? Frank has a cool program that's kind of like a network, like a studio. So I'm going to go full screen for you this time so you can actually see. Hey, look, whose freaking line is this? What chump is this? Oh, that's that Frank guy. Well, okay, cool. I have to get rid of some of my windows here. And I hear there's a little bit too much treble. We're going to have to get rid of the treble so there's no more trouble. There we go. See, I'm working with you, folks. We are going to go post-bashing. Well, not really bashing. We're just going to go inspecting. We're going to go find out what's happening in the world. I want to get some current events. And I figured, you know what? Facebook might be the place to get my news. Now, that sounds absolutely insane. It sounds like something a ding-dong would say. But in a world where all and everything is pretty much tainted, somebody's tainted it, literally, figuratively. But you're trying to get info, and you can't even, hold on, I'm going to broaden the base. You can't even get a single clue as to what is happening in the world. Nobody will tell you the truth. And you can see now that all of the info that you're getting is totally skewed. It's all different directions. Well, I'm waiting for a couple people to join. It just gets, you know, I don't want to talk to myself tonight. But, all right, we're going to get off of my page because I know my posts are up to snuff. Let's boogie down the whole avenue. What do we got here? Hey, I'm going to hide the names because I don't want to, well, not hide them, but listen, it's a public forum, but I don't want to insult people that I care about. That's the thing. So I'm not trying to insult people while I do this. I'm trying to show you. Hey, you know what this is? This is called peer review. Now we're going to peer review the posts. All right. Absolutely. The pandemic is like a marketer's dream, but rather than a product, you are being sold fear and division. Now, may I broaden on this? Let me tell you about this. You're going to blow your mind a little bit. There's a gentleman named Sigmund Freud, and he worked extensively on creating psychology that would benefit the state. And we have his, I guess this is his nephew. His nephew is, right? Yeah, nephew or brother-in-law, somebody. And is directly related, I think it says his nephew, is, the guy is named after sauce, okay? Always remember it that way. He's named after sauce. Edward Bernays. It's not spelt like the sauce, so when you go to search it, don't look for Bernays sauce, but it just for a device so you don't forget it's named after Bernays sauce. And then ironically, Bernays came up. Well, he didn't come up, but he gave the idealist prognosis that a business person, rather than help the customer have the best product, we're going to give the product, we're going to give the customer a lesser product and just train them to accept it. I'll give you the perfect example. When Devil Dogs and Cupcakes got smaller and smaller, we just keep eating them. We complain. We say, oh, look, the cupcakes are so much smaller. And of course they are. Yeah, they're smaller now. But remember, we still eat them. We just eat two. So we're not swayed by this thing that happens. We know what's happening to us, but we still go along with it. And that's kind of the problem here. You know, when you go to vote now, a day is especially, hold on, I'm going to fix the audio. When you go vote, it's like, it's more of a psychological switch. And what happens is, basically, you're getting this idea that the action you're taking by flipping a lever is going to choose a person. But honestly, the CFR, Council of Foreign Relations, works extensively with popular opinions, and they sway opinions. So you think you like this politician, but they just told you you did, and it took a long time. It took a lot for that politician to do to get you on board with what they were doing, and you went with it because they matched some criteria in your life that it settled a dispute for you. Hold on, I'm working on my audio. It settled a dispute in your own mind over the fact that maybe, maybe this person isn't so bad. You know, I don't know what to do. They don't give me any choices anymore. They give me this guy, they give me that guy, and neither of them are good. And that's part of the game. You're funneled. Your choices are funneled, bottlenecked, and limited. But oh, there goes the audio. They're limited by extreme measures, and they're really good, really, really good at getting you on board with different agenda that you have no idea you're doing. Okay, this whole straw thing, you're giving up straws. Sure, that was nice. You were trying to help a sea turtle. I'm a marine biologist. I've never seen a sea turtle that had a straw. I know they get caught in fishing nets. People didn't stop eating their fish sandwich at Burger King, but they just asked for no straw. But they kept eating the sandwich, blindly accepting the idea that the straw is going to save the world. But see, they weren't able to allow themselves to give up the sandwich. They wanted the sandwich. It's a matter of personal accountability. You've got, if the person doesn't give up the sandwich and they're not eating the straw, so it really doesn't matter if they give up the straw. They still eat the sandwich, which causes the problem. And that's what we're talking about here. It's a matter of people's personal accountability is seriously hindered. And you see, this is what I talk about with arrested development. And somewhere along the line, people are limited as to their development. And it gets a little bit harrowing trying to explain to people that have no understanding of their own accountability for something. So how could you tell them, hey, this thing's hurting people? They don't care about their own being. Why would they care about those people? And some people have never had to help anyone. They don't know what that is. Anyway, I'm getting off topic. The trick here is selling fear and division is what the UN wants. They want you panicked. If you look at young Greta, you know Greta Thunberg? Well, little Miss Greta is an elitist little rich girl, okay? And there's a quote of hers which says, I want you to panic. I want you to run around and light the houses on fire. That's what her job is. She may not know the full ramifications of what she's doing, little Greta, but I could guarantee you that young Greta is well aware of a certain aspect of her persona, because it's trademarked. Greta's trademarked. In case you haven't noticed, they trademarked the Greta name. Like the, it's like a franchise. It's like McDonald's. It's creepy. It doesn't make sense. Why are they why did they franchise Greta? I don't really understand why anybody would put a trademark after the name. It's a strange thing, unless there was something else happening. And, you know, that's the way it goes. But here's this young girl, comes out of nowhere, and now she's telling people about chemtrails. So, what's that? You know, I mean, when we have... I'm trying to fix my audio, folks. I'm so sorry. Is that better? No. Is that better? It's just really... It's... There we go. Oh my God, it's so hard. I'm trying to do this like professionally so that you can actually listen like a human being and not listen to me like Max Headroom. But and as I go, I got headphones on, and it wasn't quite the same before. So anyway, the whole point I'm trying to make is that with the this is a brilliant post, and that's what's happening. And the idea is if they can get enough people panicked and running around like chickens, they're wearing masks is an act of submission. You understand? Because there's no real virus pandemic. It's nonsense. And the actual thing that this is derived from kills less than, what, 1%? Come on, folks. It's a silly thing happening. And they could have told you yellow fever. They could have told you, like, malaria. They could have told you everything. And you would have just run like, some people would have just run like this. Because they're used to taking the orders from the box in the living room. It's just the way it is. Let me move on so I can keep my train of thought. But, yeah. And the idea is if you put that mask on, for no apparent reason, even against doctors' warnings that it's going to make you sick if you wear it, then obviously there's something wrong. There's there's a disconnect in your understanding of what you're here for. You kind of missed the boat. You're not here for taking orders. The government works for you. Wasn't that the way it goes? Never underestimate the power of stupid people in large groups. That's absolutely true. Michelle, thank you. By the way, Sal, great post. Great post. And my dear Michelle, yes, perfect. I'd love to hear his thoughts on everything going on right now. I miss him. You and me as well, Michelle. Let me go ahead and give you one of the old Facebook reactions. Now, I'm going to tell you about reactions, okay? You notice on YouTube, there's tons of reaction videos. They got you reacting because they want to see what makes you tick. Why, Frank? Why do they want to do that? Well, because because they have computer models of us. And I wrote some stuff down so that I keep myself on track tonight. And basically, yeah, there's computer models of us that are working behind the scenes to give some group of people all the info on us, what makes us tick, what makes the whole program in our brain work. And they can actually, through this process, through this computer system thing, which is called artificial intelligence, and it's an algorithm system that runs off code, runs off different types of sequence of events, sequences of events, like how long someone looks at a post or a picture, how long it takes someone to read a page, how long someone lingers on a post. And that little camera is watching your eye movements on the phone, and on your computer, while you look at posts, the posts aren't there for your benefit. They're using that as the cheese in the maze. So the post is the cheese, and the post gets you looking and reacting and liking and loving and all this stuff. You get what I'm saying here? And that's what it's all about. And because we have no more of a market economy here, it's all about this reaction. So data is being sold, and it's not just your phone number. It's data on how you live, on what you look like inside, not what you look like outside. They could care less about that. They wouldn't know what your brain does. So how long I'm on this post here, that's going to tell my algorithm what it should put into my recommendations. It's a simple thing. But it goes deeper than that. Somewhere there's a kitchen table with you and your family at it in a computer, a three-dimensional little picture. I mean, it's a simulated three dimensions. It's Sims. They're playing the Sims with your life. Don't think I'm please, don't think I'm serious. Go look it up. they call it archetype reality. So just check that out. Alternate reality, virtual, not virtual reality, but it's artificial reality, AR, alternate or artificial reality. Anyway, yep. And in large groups, here's what happens. You have a democracy, right? 51 to 49 wins. Well, what if the 59% that won, or 51% that won the fact that they could have children shot at will? And the 49% obviously didn't want that. So that's a problem, right? So we, you know, that's not really, democracy isn't obviously the best among other, but it is, as what's his name said, the best among the other systems. Well, we got rid of it now. You have no democracy anymore. You never really did have the true Greek democracy. Like, here's an example. Greek democracy didn't include people. It included only citizens. Citizens were only the rich. So lower class people, like just me and you, like working dogs, people, like, you know, and women, children, they weren't citizens. You don't get citizenship in ancient Greece, where democracy comes from. The demos for the people was, It was basically a dictation. It was an authoritarian dictum from a group of people. It was almost communist socialism. So what they called democracy, it was only voted up in the council. There was only votes among the I can't think of the word right now. Won't come to the Senate. The Senate votes, not the people. Now, we're talking republic, so we want to talk like representational government, where we vote for someone who represents our needs, something that we as a group decide upon. But you know that the group decision is always skewed, because the television box, as we discussed before, leads them down crazy paths. Everything coming off TV is fake or tampered, okay? And large groups create mass confusion, and also they also create mob rule. And I only have so much time, so we're going through these things pretty quickly, but I will make sure that if you have any questions, and I, is my audio good? Let me check here. I got to check my Facebook page to see if my audio is good. Nobody's even there. Oh, somebody's there. That's a good thing. Oh, Vicky. Hi, Vicky. I just don't know if the audio is good or not, and I've been having problems with my audio. I don't have the right equipment for this stuff. But anyway, or the brains to know how to set up microphone audio for podcasts. I used to just talk into the computer. But the clicking when I type is no good. So anyway, we're going to move through a couple things. Anyway, let's boogie. So yeah, large people, okay, you're going to get mob rule. And then if let's say only 51% makes up the decision, If half, only if only half of that 51% had been able to be coerced, it would kind of push the other half to maybe, well, some of the other half would go along with that other half that was coerced. They would say, well, you know what? Maybe they're right. And, you know, they might have been consciously just okay with the decision. The YouTube channel, which one? Is that mine, you mean? I don't know, Bill, I don't know which one you mean. I might have said something. I'm on a delay. They have a delay for where it goes, you know, and I talk and stuff. So, Bill, please fill me in on what you mean. I'm not sure. I might have said something, and now my brain doesn't remember. I can't remember from 1 minute to the next, and I get lost, like, mid-sentence. So, please, I apologize. But the large group thing, when you get, like, that half of the 51%, that's not much. And if they're swayable, they might even convince a few of the others. And then slowly they could whittle away at the last 25%. And this, bam, we got it. Mine, if you go onto YouTube, it's Frank G. Fish 21 Ferrante. But if you just do the hashtag G. Fish 21 or OTB 21, you can just, if you do that in the search, anywhere on Google especially, you'll see my channel should come up. I should have an easier title just for my channel so it'd be easier to search. But I was never thinking about it. I kind of got, you know, I'm scattered. But yeah, you could just search OTB21 in the hashtag OTB21. Or you could just go to the search on Google on YouTube and you'll find me. OTB21, outside the box. But yeah, so the idea is that... when people are swayable, they're swayable. You know how it is. It's the way it goes. Thank you for asking, Bill. I appreciate it. All right, let's boogie down and see who we got now. Hey, Matt, hey, that's a pretty cool picture. You know who that is, folks. Let's say, folks, do you know who does this work right here? It looks like, look at the brush strokes. You see those little individual strokes right there? That's a tell to some of these paintings is the brushstroke style and this pixelated styling of painting where individual little slabs of yellow. Here, I'll give us a art. I used to do some teaching of art for FGCU College. I used to teach some adults after, you know, like and at the university. It was cool. But anyway, you see, like, there's individual lines in the light. It's not just a straight line down. This guy did all the lines are going in the same direction. And I'm going to say that this would be... we don't know. It's beautiful, though, isn't it? I can't remember his name. I think it's Gauguin. I'm pretty sure. I don't know. Anyway, let's move down. Ironically enough, when you make peace with the fact that the purpose of life is not happiness, but rather experience and growth, happiness comes as a natural byproduct. When you are not seeking it, it is the objective, and it will find its way to you. That's absolutely brilliant. Thank you, Matt. You're always making me smile. Michelle, breaking news. China reports case of dengue fever on the same day it detects bubonic plague. Well, you know, these are the things we're talking about, that they try to scare the crud out of people, and they put people into a shock, and it's horrible. People are in deer in headlight mode. People really are in deer headlight mode. They just don't know which way to run, and I don't blame them. I get nasty, but I'm sorry. I don't blame people. I know this is terrifying. This is not fun. Night scope that's coming up right here is very important. But right here, this is just to amplify fear. That's all. They have plenty of dengue fever, which dengue fever is basically yellow fever. And that's not foreign. That's a normal thing. You get malaria. Bubonic plague, I don't know so much about that. That might be a little silly. But, of course, it's coming from the Daily Mail. I mean, these news outlets, they literally are like the old Inquirer. It's a simple thing. Nightscope. Okay, this is your nightmare. Nightscope is the nightmare. You know, and what this is right here, These are the new police force. Okay? This is the new police force. So, if you're interested to find out what exactly is going to be taking over for the police department, that. And they have a lot of them. They are wired to kill. They have a kill order implanted by a human being back at the old studio, you know, back at the old office. And the sad part is that if you mess with them, they will actually... they're going to actually do something violent, and they will call out another force. So they have like multiple forces that will come get you, but they don't have police patrolling. That's the new police patrol right there. Another thing is this all runs on 5G, which increases all the 5G radiation infrastructure. So when they have the excuse now to throw 5G into the mix because they have to have a police force involved, I hate that nobody listens to my show. It just blows. Anyway, it's okay. You know, this is it's just the way it goes. Two people popped in. I'm very, very happy for that. The thing is, though, you see, I get asked all day long by people to help them, and nobody, and the same people just don't want to watch the video, but that's okay. I mean, I'm not going to hold it against them. You know, they can't follow. I get it. Or they don't want to. I annoy them. Who knows? I don't really know. Anyway, this thing is a nightmare, okay? They're asking you, the public. See, look, there's anger faces. People know what this is. And the point is that, yeah, it's very bad. And look, they want you, the public, to pay for it. Do you understand? Oh, I lost my headphones. You, the public, to pay for this. Isn't that something? That's nice. Thanks. Good. Keep working on it. Okay, I don't even want to go. I don't know what that. Let's see. I'm looking for stuff that's controversial. I'm trying to find about world, you know. Let's see. The universe has no respect for you 100%. If you can't wear a mask and wash your hands and have social respect. Tom Hanks has no respect for me. Well, yeah, okay. This is a freak right here who wears $1 million. He's got no mask on in that picture. He's a schmuck. He didn't. And if he said that, who gives a rat's ass? Who cares about Tom Hanks? Dude, that son of a bitch should be marooned for real. Nobody cares. Listen, there is no pandemic. It's a computer model being run, and the info that they're putting in there, false data, is so they can continue this nightmare, and it's to take over your freedom, and you have no idea. Most people don't have a clue. Here you go. Communicate without cellular restriction. Yeah, this is more radiation, okay? More radiation. Is anybody listening? Is anyone there? Wow. Don't ask later. Okay, yeah, I get tired. Somebody picked up quick. I don't really care if anybody listens. People listen on my YouTube. Anyway, here we go. Here's some more Wi-Fi 5G stuff that you're going to get. And it's really small. You know where it goes? I bet. It goes right in your ears, right next to your brain. And it has all kinds of software in there. And this thing actually runs in the same frequency as our cell phone. And what happens is 2.4 gigahertz off our cell phone causes diabetic reactions. They use it to create diabetic reactions in rats so they could study it diabetes for humans and humans. And the point is, they want more money again, Indiegogo, from you to do it. Here is Tom Hanks, the asswipe. But here's the real fun, is that another company wants you to pay for automated police. Right here, the automated police force right there. And it's all 5G. Nightscope is at the forefront of commercializing autonomous tech. That's 5G, okay? And look, service business model. That means a computer model. Again, I tell you, all of this is computer models. They have said this already a million times, that everything they're doing is based on computer models. All of global warming, BS, hoax that it is going off of the computer models. And the same scientists in the same breath tell you, or tell people, the public, I have quotes and I'll show you. They have quotes saying, oh yeah, the computer models are highly inaccurate. Anyway, there's a new police force. We're going to move down. This looks like some kind of toothbrush set. But this is all 5G. And that means an increased 5G infrastructure, which means more radiation, which means really doesn't matter how many people are around, because we'll be too weak to actually fight these things. And they're rigged with the kill switch. They actually have to be programmed by a human to kill. And they already have been out in the street working from different companies. This is not DARPA, or it might be DARPA. But again, they're asking for money. See, they're asking for cash. They want your investments, starting at $1,000. See, you pay for your demise here. Okay, so we're going to move down to some more politics. Fine. So Tom Hanks wants you to social distance. He's got no respect, and he's a pedophile. That's nice. That's nice. Let's move down. Another, so I told you, Indiegogo, the first offline transistor earbuds. Okay, yeah, that's just bad. You don't want that in your head, okay? I'm proclaiming a elites hunting season this fall. That's absolutely amazing. I love this guy. Yes, that makes sense. I'm going to give you a heart for that one. I'll join the team. When you hear the second wave, think chemtrails. Either that, or believe that Fauci and Gates are psychic when it comes to pandemics. Yeah. Listen, folks, yeah, there's what the second wave is just another scare. Now, look, if they wanted to wipe us off the planet, it's very easy. That's not the goal here. The goal is to sheeple us, and also it's to slowly whittle the population down to the strongest. This is The Thinning. That movie, The Thinning, is basically the metaphor of this experience. And I'm going to show you some videos in this video, if I have time, of people at the UN saying we have to depopulate, and it might be epidemic. It might be this, it might be that. Yeah, okay, we're going to move on. Hold on. Let's see, we're on the wrong page. So, yeah, second wave's coming. It's going to be very unique. They're not letting us off the mask thing, and they're going to increase that. In stores now, in all of the schools now, is biometrics. Biometrics scans your body on the inside and out. So it's really bad that children, that they've been out of school, while they've been out in the schools, they've been installing 5G biometrics. The same stuff that's at the airport, even more intensified with more technology that can scan you for health issues. Everybody's walking around with thermometers measuring your temperature. Get away from me. And so there's no more bubble of you being protected by some kind of deity. They don't go by that. The scientific socialist type idealist doesn't have religion protecting the people. You're not allowed to have religion. You get the state religion, which is like earth religion. Okay, Kanye for press. So, yeah, when you see VPs and vice presidents and all this stuff, remember this, please. The UN has taken policy control of the United States back in 19, 92. And Nancy Pelosi, if you'd like, at the end of this, I'll show the video. Nancy, it's only a couple minutes. Nancy Pelosi is explaining to the UN that the U.S. would be thrilled to lead the way in implementing the Rio Summit. I'm quoting word for word because I can remember that the U.S. would be thrilled to lead the way in implementing the Rio Summit, the Earth Charter, the Rio Summit treaties, and to lead for Agenda 21. The U.S. wants to lead for Agenda 21. Now, I'm going to put the link for that video so you can look at it yourself. There's no sense in me putting it up now, wasting time. You can look at it later, and there's your proof. But Nancy Pelosi said this. She did this. They were all involved. This was on CNBC back in 92. I was at college. I was doing my thing. So, I don't know why people can't listen for more than a few minutes. This is kind of confusing. It's okay. I don't really mind. Now I got to talk to myself for a few minutes, which really blows chunks. Excuse me. Cough. Oh, there's someone came back. Thank God. That's good because, you know, I don't like talking to myself. Okay, so let's move along here. You know, it's difficult when I'm talking to myself out here. That's a really cool video. When I'm talking to myself out here, I just lose hope in all this. Okay, so we got some kind of Lamborghinis, right? Yeah, sure. Okay, we don't want to go near that. Kittens. That's my... All right. Right, surely the shit show is a fraud. Yes, and the fraud is not so much... Okay, listen, it's not so much a fraud where they're outwardly lying about something, but what they do is they've created a simulation, and I can show you the website that offers the simulation, and Q is part of this. What they do is they take our models of us, all models of all of us, and basically they poke, they prod, they starve. I'm going to show you all of this stuff. I'll give you the post. They poke, prod, do all that stuff, and they find out what makes each of us tick. And by doing that, they can go ahead and see if a famine has some effect or if a pandemic has an effect or whatever. Now, the companies, I have all the websites. It's not like a big, you know, it isn't a hidden conspiracy. H.G. Wells has a book called The Open Conspiracy. Yeah, that's what this is. All right, let me just... It's always a nice thing. Okay, now look, folks, the trees. Erase your carbon. Here, we're going to play a game. I'm going to give her a nasty, and I hope I get some kind of response. I'm the only person who probably put in an angry out of the 1,000 people who like this. And I could tell you why I don't like her. She's some superstar nobody who they turned into a star. But let me tell you one more thing. Without listening to her, I can tell you that this tree BS is BS, exactly what it is. First of all, the UN and Harvard are working together to create a 5G network. 5G cannot be hindered by trees. So, first of all, that's number one. Number two, this Ecosia BS, where they want to plant a tree for every time you do a search, is BS. If you kill a tree, you kill the entire network of life around it. There's a mini ecosystem around each tree. Okay, this is vitally important. That mini ecosystem can't be replaced by simply regrowing a tree. Okay, tree farms and trees in the forest, it's two separate things. So if the rate that they told us the rainforest was being taken out, if that rate was accurate, there would be no more complaints about the trees in the rainforest being taken out. They would be gone by now. They wouldn't be there anymore. It's been so long. Those trees have been taken out forever. They've been literally demise all over the place. And you know, you got these people telling you're going to plant trees while the same people that are hiring these little minions these minions on YouTube and stuff that pump all this, or on Facebook that pump these videos. You listen, if you want to plant the trees, you're going to have to go against the UN and Harvard, who don't want the trees. Harvard, and I quote, says, "We have less trees now, and that's better." Harvard's saying that we will cool the planet with less trees. Why doesn't that ring in anybody's head like a bell? Harvard is saying trees are getting in the way of our carbon capture. Well, you could see the relation. They have a carbon capture scheme where they can capture carbon. Here's this young lady who's telling you to capture your carbon. Erase your carbon with Melissa Joan Hart. What? What am I going to erase my carbon with Melissa for? Who is this person? And why is she some carbon expert? She's a meat stick on Facebook. She's some kind of actress. But she wants me to erase my carbon by planting trees. Now, look. I planted a lot of trees in my lifetime on my own. I didn't have to be told. And the thing is, all this beach cleanup. I used to clean up beaches all the time when I walked on them. You bring a bag with you and throw it out at the end of your walk. It's so easy. It's like you don't need a movement to get to clean a beach. Okay? Hold on. My cat is doing things. My cat has to go in and out all the time, and he doesn't understand how to use a cat window. I have a cat door, and the cat is not bright enough. So, talking about not bright enough, people believe now, they're being tricked to believe, that their breath, their gas, is causing a problem on the planet's temperature. CO2 does not heat the planet up as much as the methane, as much as all the other stuff. Now, obviously, trees take CO2 up, but they don't want more trees. They want carbon sinks. So do your research later. Look up Harvard, plastic grass, plastic lawns, plastic trees. They're putting up plastic trees from Harvard. I don't understand why I can't keep people's attention. It's sad. I suck at this, don't I? Is it me, or is it just getting to a wonderful gift not to hear from Beto? I don't know who that is. I'm going to keep moving. All right, let's move around here. Anyway, I got a buddy here named Tim Ritchie. If you want to check out, he's doing some great work. Mosaic chemical plant here in Florida has polluted our waters, something fierce. But I have to tell you, there's something behind it. The regulations they're given, the regulations they're forced to take, and the way that they're forced to make money is limited. They get funneled. So the point is, so the company itself might have some good people in there that want to do good things by regulating, but of course their hands are tied by red tape. So the point is that when we, right now the UN, since 1992, has been setting up really poor infrastructure policy that brings down the regulatory ability for these big companies. So the big companies end up polluting. And then when the big companies pollute, we go outside with pitchforks and signs, and we want the company shut down. What happens is the UN has a sneaky back door. They come in and automate the company. Well, if humans can't do this work, we have an automated squad. When I say the UN, these people are so vast. They have finger in every single hole of the bowling balls. They have bowling ball in both hands. Literally, I don't know how to make a better analogy. They literally have a claw in everything, and they have 100 claws. they run. If you go, what I want you to do for yourself, when you see posts that are pushed heavily, when you see advertisements pushed so heavily you can't stand them, do some digging on who supports them. Go down to their about section. Go down to find out about the company. Do some research on the CEO. You'll find deep connections within the UN's subsidizing all these companies because they work with sustainability. It's the trigger. It's a catchphrase. Sustainability. Now, what happens when we shut down Mosaic, which is a good thing because they're polluting, and I'm a marine biologist, I can tell you that right now all the shellfish are dead everywhere. Shellfish are all over the place, underwater, not out of the water, but underwater, dead, open and dead. And that any biologist would tell you that the shellfish, being a filter feeder, will die first because they get hit with the toxin right off the bat. They're taking in that water. The fish isn't eating the water. The fish is filtering the water with its gills. The filter feeder takes in the water and filters particles, but it eats the good stuff that's in the water, little tiny microscopic stuff. Anyway, it's not a bio lesson. But the point is that once this company gets shut down, the possibility is that the UN backdoors, and the UN comes in and says, hey, well, we have a better proposal for how we can handle this thing. We're going to keep this company open. We're going to still mine, but we're going to give you a better regulation. So this whole thing was a setup, and it was they had time to wait. No, listen, they don't do things overnight. They take time. So, you know, I can show you the paperwork where they started these initiative properties. Now, the regulatory experiences are all on paper. They're all searchable, and they're all from the UN's policy from 1992 Rio Summit. The Earth Charter, Mikhail Gorbachev wrote that book. And they're using that as the basis for the Rio Summit. Now, what's the Rio Summit? They go there and they put on those little bathing suits. And they get to those special wax jobs. And they drink special drinks with little, you know, little umbrellas. I'm not kidding you. They show only pictures because you and I are not allowed to go. You're not allowed to know. You're only invited to these things, and they're all the elite people and their little minions. And they seriously, if you've ever been to a local meeting, you know how they work. People go, they get their coffee and donut, they sit there, they just wait for it to be over. Is the vote finished? I'm tired. This is boring. Because nothing gets done in government. And even government on a global scale, nothing gets done. They make us do it. They've got whites pitted against blacks, Chinese pitted against this guy, everybody pitted against everyone. And all we're all on the same team. We're all on the same boat. And the UN has us killing each other. Not physically, but emotionally, mentally. People can't handle this, man. They're falling apart. They're breaking really hard. People are just coming apart. I don't know if you've noticed, but they're literally just crumbling. There's suicides, and I'm not laughing at this. There are suicides increasing. It's very terrible. And another thing, I wrote some stuff down. Children's commercials now on YouTube, they're like 4 + 4 = 8, and they're cartoons. They have nothing to do with selling. They're trying to sell YouTube as your new platform where you should, like, literally live there. So I got to give Tim Ritchie so much credit and Frank Kondros. They've done so much work to shut this place down. I'm so scared, though, that the UN might backdoor them and come in and take all that good work they did to get this place, you know, regulated. Oh, the UN is, they're sneaky. They've been doing this for a long time. And they got people like, what's his name there? I'll think of it. You got to give me a second. First of all, George Clooney works for the UN. He works with the Council of Foreign Relations. George Clooney, he's an actor. Like I said, they have fingers in everything. My friend's dog died. Anyway, that's my friend from school, high school. Okay, now here, using this device to scan your home, hotel rooms, and give you a great sense of security. There are hidden cams watching everywhere. Well, this is a paranoia trick right here to get you freaked out, but this is actually pretty damn cool. I think I want to get one. Honestly, that's pretty cool. But this is a statement, folks, for you as a human being to know that there's something very wrong in your world where there's this many cameras. There's a reason why we were outfitted with phones that have cameras. There's a reason why we were given cameras to such a degree. Marshall McLuhan and I'm going to show a video probably later on tonight, can give a real good example of this in the video called Children of the Future. And he talks about how they get children to learn about video. It's important for them because this world deals with a visual context as a way of thinking. It's visual thinking. People have gone 3D thought and they do visual thinking because we stare into these boxes. And, you know, TV started that. We went from Gutenberg literal man who reads, literal human who reads, to this staring at unrelated individual images. That started in the 70s with the commercials where they flashed from image to image. Guy jumping off a diving board. The next image is a guy blowing that conch shell. The next image is a girl in a bikini with a towel. The next image, they jump. They have no continuity. You know, there's no continuity like that water on the older commercials. And that got people separated from their relation to events because they don't understand a chain of events anymore. They can't be like Gutenberg thinkers, meaning someone who reads in a book, reads word for word, line by line, and you have to do one at a time, like dominoes. What's this post right here? Vicky, what are we seeing? Oh, boy. Yeah, well, that's a heavy flow right there. Holy cow. All men are created equal. Nope. And neither are women, and neither are anybody else. No animals are equal. Equality is dangerous. And let me tell you why. Equality means that everybody is equally poor. Equality can mean that people can be made equally sad, equally shot, equally run over with cars. The thing about equality is that some people are more equal than others. And we know that from Orwell's Animal Farm. The point is, you can't make an equal society if you want to have individuals in this society. You can have individuals of a like kind, but that's not an individualist society. So we're talking about collectivist versus individualism here. And this is an important thing. And I discuss this often. We don't have much time left. I'm almost done because my voice is going. I got about 8 minutes. I'm going to boogie through some more posts. Thank you for sticking with me, whoever you are. I appreciate it. All men are created equal. That's some men are some men are just, they're not even men these days. They're like monsters. This is freaking really important right here. I'm leave with a couple of really important things here. The UN has said since 1972, we are going to get meat off your menu. Now, in this last episode of this show, where I go through posts, Guerrilla Radio, I actually showed you a post that says the CDC, CNBC put the news article out. They put the journalist article out, I guess you call journalism. But it says that meat will be off the menu and made obsolete. Eating meat will be made obsolete in 15 years or less. And I told you this a long time ago because the UN told me this. The people at the UN are very open about policy. And what they're doing right now is getting meat off the table because they say that high intake of meat, air conditioning, suburban housing, those kind of things, it's not sustainable. Sustainability comes from a zero-sum mentality of economics. Zero sum means you starting with a certain amount of something. That's not the case. You can birth more cow. I don't just say cow eating cows is necessarily good or bad. For this example, you can grow more cow. I'll give you the example of the tree farm. If a tree grows and the product that's going to be cut won't be for 100 years, the human you sell it to doesn't live for 100 years. How are they going to see profits from your tree farm? How are you as a tree farmer going to grow a tree that you can sell and make money to live and become rich before you ever cut the tree down? Well, every year that tree grows a few inches, it's more than it was before. So you started with the seed. You grew this tree, and every year it became more valuable because each year it can be cut. It can be used for something, toothpicks or something. So every year that wood grows, it becomes more and more valuable. Now, the people who are willing to invest in your business are going on the fact that, on the assumption that you know how to grow trees. So not with all of that on the side, because that brings out too much, with all that on the side, the fact that let's say you're a great tree grower and they know this, they're going to invest in you. But you're not going to be able to cut your tree down. So you pass the tree farm down to your next of kin or someone you trust. And the point is, that's how some kind of a business structure works, where a person won't see the benefit. So you don't have to rape a forest to get rich off a tree farm. Excuse me. You can, and you don't have to cut the trees before their time. This is the trick. So you can trim the trees. You can do a Christmas tree farm or grow the smaller tree. And those are good things. Christmas tree farm's good. Cutting down the forest, bad idea, again, because you kill 100 different microorganisms that live around the tree, and you can't replenish them. And then if you take a whole forest and you burn the thing down, then you've really killed off maybe a whole species, I mean extinct, of specific microorganisms that need the tree needs through symbiosis to live. Symbiosis is they live together in harmony. And even parasite needs the tree. And that parasite feeds something else. Everything in nature is in a chain. We're not separate from the moon. I mean, you know, we're not on it, but we are part of it because it made us. The stuff that the moon is made of, we're made of. It's Earth stuff. And Mars stuff. And here's a fun one. I'll just drop this last thing. Gold is the last element that comes from an exploding star. So as the star finally implodes and poof, and just disappears, gold is burst out into space. That's why it's fairly rare, okay? And it's really kind of like considered valuable. Well, more than that, it's a good circuit maker. Gold is great for circuitry, and it's also good for space stuff. That's a side note. Anyway, the meat thing, they want meat off the table. This is part of it. They're going to get you. You're going to see a lot of this meat off the table. Okay, I don't want to get through that. Some folks are just fun. I don't want to make my friends sad. Video robot. Access to... What? Text-to-speech. Okay, this is artificial intelligence, folks. Lifelike a... You know, they're creating 3D models with us. They're making a little Sims game, and I have all the website stuff for it. There's real companies. Ray Kurzweil is someone you should keep your eyes on. Ray Kurzweil, he made Kurzweil speakers. The guy was a writer, sci-fi, a lot of stuff. Very, very popular. He makes masks now that have electronic circuitry involved. The whole thing, I told you I was going to tell you about sleepers. Sleepers. What is a sleeper? Well, someone like me, for example. I'm telling you that the paper mask won't block out micron-sized particles. It won't even touch atomic particles, okay? Which is your vape pen. Your vape pen, if someone's vaping, will get right through the mask, okay? Now dig this. If I tell you this, this sets up a movement, because you tell a friend, you tell a friend, he tells a friend. Everybody tells a friend that the mask is inefficient. So the next thing you know, and the this is what they have me do, this is a chess game. Remember, this is a very clever, intricate, organized chess game. So my role is to eventually come out and say, hey, these stupid masks don't work because you're not getting any protection. So the next thing happens is you see a whole bunch of posts, mandatory better masks are being made. Bam. And the next thing you know, you're wearing some newfangled mask. You can't breathe. You're recirculating your own CO2. You're recirculating your all kinds of bacteria, giving yourself a fungal infection in your lungs. Number five, you with that mask, you also lose identity with another human being. Facial gesture is extremely important for social integration. Don't forget that. It's very vital. Without facial expression reading, we can't socially integrate. And we can kill each other if so need be. So creating a civil war is easy when people can't see faces. Very simple. And people behind a mask take on a different persona. Ask the boys in Slipknot. They have admitted that when they put the mask on, they become a different person. Someone they couldn't be during normal life. Sociologists call it the bathroom face versus the social face, the outside face. Anyway, we're going to move down. That's just more artificial intelligence that the internet, I'm going to go fast because I'm almost done, the internet of things will be using for a brain. And I told you, there's that night scope, it's called, automated police force, and DARPA's got their police force. Well, that stuff has brain that it uses on its own. It's artificial intelligence. It's autonomous. It doesn't run like a remote control. It doesn't need a signal. It can send signals and take signals. It doesn't need that to run, and it doesn't need that for the kill decision, which really creeps me out. Let's see. Let's move along here. I only have a couple left, so I just want to boogie it down. Okay, I'm going to give you this last one right here. This is a perfect one. John Fry, nice to see you again, buddy. The U.S. is withdrawing from the World Health Organization. Okay, first thing, World Health Organization works for the U.N. Again, I'm so tired of saying these words. When you have to say things over and over, you get tired of it. But yes, okay. So the U.S. is not withdrawing from the World Health Organization. They can't. You know why? Because the U.N. runs U.S. policy. Since 1992, they've been in full control. Ask Nancy Pelosi. They've been in full control of our policy, both foreign and domestic. So when someone tells me something goofy, like, oh my God, we're going to be taken out of the World Health Organization. No, you're not. And it wouldn't matter. The World Health Organization is, they work for the UN. So this is all part of the ruse. This is to make you think that the old government system we had has completely failed. Listen, Trump is brilliant. He's a good actor as well. Have you ever listened to his early speeches? The man is really smart. He's not stupid. He plays dumb well. Listen, what you're seeing on TV with these presidents, it's a wrestling match. That we still fall in love with the bad guy. They have to give you the antagonist and the protagonist. You have to have an enemy. And now anti-hero is the new world situation. So, yeah, no, we're not. A U.S., doesn't exist. The U.S. has been absorbed by the U.N.'s globalist experience. They just haven't really made everybody quite aware because of this one fact that people, like I told you before, that 51% really can push people around. Mob rules, man. You can't, you're going to fight the mob? They're going to beat you up. So they're going to lynch us. So the point is, you can't fight upstream forever. You get tired. You're only human. We're only human. Listen, you made it this far? Holy cow. Are you kidding? You made it this far. This lucid dreamer. This is advanced sleep mask. This stuff has, what you call it inside, electronic signaling stuff, which rewires our brains. Sure, it looks like a whole bunch of fun. Well, the monkey and the rat and all that, they wouldn't take the bait and do the experiment if it didn't look like fun to them. They wouldn't go find the end of the maze if it didn't have cheese at it. You see, this thing is integrated with a chip. You don't want this on you. Trust me, you don't want this. This is not a video. This is the dreams they want to give you. This is insanity, folks. That's not something you want to mess with. Believe me, this is so bad. Anyway, we'll move on. Hey, Darren, my buddy. This is a great artist, by the way. I'm going to give him a shout out. He's in all the way out in Australia. Good man. Anyway, I'm going to be able to leave, I think, on this note. Let's see what this say. Oh, here we go. This is perfect. You might not want to hear this, but forcing people to wear masks has nothing to do with safety. It is an experiment to see who's a follower and who isn't. That is one of the most brilliant posts. Sarah, always, as always, going to give you full credit. Yeah. See, look, we didn't have to bash anybody. People are catching on. I'm so freaking proud of you. I'd say some dirty words, but I can't. So, listen, I love you folks. I'm going to drop it. I don't want to make this more than too long. It's like an hour show. But, yeah, it is absolutely, absolutely. This is an experiment. This is all shown in computer models. Do your research. You don't have to look far. Recommendations, don't search Google Chrome or some of the bigger, well-known search engines, because what you're going to, and don't use words that are common amongst the, you know, amongst the common crowd, because then you'll end up going down rabbit holes. You got to find a good way. I search like this. The great things that 5G is doing. And you're going to get a whole different algorithm. Tell me what the best part of such and such vaccine is. You get such a great learning curve. And you, and when you know that all of that's skewed and biased, it's so simple. Listen, I'm going to run. I don't want to make this too long. There's so much more I want to talk about. But like I said, it's just like, oh my God, I'm overwhelmed with stuff. There's so much. But hey, I want to thank you for checking it out and listening. And if you have anything you want to add in the comments, please feel free. You know, this is just something I'm doing right now to kind of, you know, hopefully create some awareness. I know maybe connect some vibes for people. I mean, not connect some vibes, connect some dots, you know. So, hey, thanks for listening. I appreciate it. And the best thing you could do, don't wear the mask. I'll put the medical PDF down in the comments. If you don't want to wear the mask out there, you're doing the world a justice by not. Because if you don't wear it, you're actually standing up for freedom, and you're standing up for liberty, and you're standing up for what people died for this country, for right to choose. Folks, you know, this is your world. You got to do with it what you will. But I want to thank you for listening. I want to just say, hey, you know, you can only do so much. Try to do it right. Try not to let people tell you what to do, and just think for yourself. That's all it takes. Personal accountability and self-respect. You got this one. You got this covered. I'll see you folks later. Have a good night.